Hello, Quake family, and welcome back to the Quake Pro League. Joined this week by the wonderful, the fantastic, I am 40 Animals. Hey, dear mate.
Doing well, man. I fixed my chair, reinforced it. I think it's going to be good. I'm ready.
Oh, yeah. You had the, what was it, the plague of the cheesecake last week?
It was a whole thing. It was very emotional. I took a couple weeks, you know, to reinforce the chair, a lot of 2x4s, a lot of trips to the lumber yard, but I think we should be good. Jackie, how have you been?
I've been good, mate. Thank you for asking. I've been all right. I've just been vibing, you know what I mean? Just living my life, enjoying the movie that is this floating rock for you. But it's good to be back with you, mate. And I'm glad I'm joined by you this week, as we've got some fantastic games coming up. And what better time than to step into the schedule and have a bit of a look at them, right? And start to work our way through, because it's only going to get better as the day goes on. Some amazing games through and through. And I'm just excited that I'm going to be on the mic with you for it all.
It's always nice to bounce off of you, Jackie. Yeah, day full of frags again. That's what Sundays are for, as we're taking a look at the schedule right now. And there's no better way to say it. I'm excited, man. I'm excited.
That's good. That's good. And you bloody well should be, mate, because we're opening up with CNZ versus Raisy. We're going to see a little bit more Raisy action, right? Obviously, he's been a huge topic of discussion of what his form's like after the last stage finals. I personally can't wait for that one, and I'm glad it's coming first and forefront to start us off. Then Nosfer Effortless, Stramis Genic. Oh, and man, look at game four.
Cypher Talks. That is legends, to say the least. Always love to see when they can battle it out, man. That one's going to be a keeper for sure.
Yeah, they give us so much, right? I'm hoping we actually do get like full force Tox coming out in that one, living his movies. I'm having a quick glance ahead at the Vita that's on there, actually. Doesn't seem like there's enough speed for Tox for me. All right, only the one. I think it's just Anarchy he's actually pulled out. So a little bit scared already.
Yeah, Cypher did a good job of making sure no slash and even taking the Strog away from him. But I mean, look, I'm an NA kid, okay? Nosfer Effortless, Dramas Genic, I'm ready.
They're drawing you in. Those are the games.
Oh, I love it. When Nosfer and Effortless play, it's always magic. It's always magic. I'm excited, man. Gotta rep the NA boys.
Yeah, you definitely do. I mean, it's what me and Dan have been talking about a lot, in the sense that I think we had in the standings, it was nearly an even split of EU slash NA, which is crazy, really, when you think about how things were looking back in like stage one. The fact we've got this close now with the actual, you know, the skill gap really between regions is crazy for me.
The boys are getting stronger, okay? They're practicing, they're hitting the gym, they're lifting, they're doing what they need to do to get yoked and put up a better fight. I mean, let's be honest, it was a little rough at first, but I mean, they're rolling now. So I got pride in my boys. I got faith.
Good. No, that's positive. I'm glad you say they've been hitting the gym. Obviously, you yourself, you know, I imagine all the lifting of the
I don't even know how to spell
probably.
Gym, Jackie, but... You know.
It's really weird, right? Because I tried to go to the gym for the Wild 40, but every time I'd go, I'd get really sweaty. I felt like a shortness of breath. I didn't feel good. I'd wake up with like sore muscles. I think I might be allergic.
I don't think it's good for you. Those all are bad signs. So stay away. Doctor's orders.
Yeah. Stay home and play Quake. So we do have some more Quake action coming up later on in the show as well. Let's get back into the schedule and see the second four games that are going to be coming up a little bit later in the evening. 40, what's sticking out to you like a sore thumb?
I mean, the Accountant versus the Outlaw, DeHang and Dewey. Is Outlaw Dewey just going to go on the run with a one frag victory? We will see. But then we got Venger Base, Kilsen Cooler, Battle of the Champs. Let's talk about that one. That might be on the Cypher Talks level. I don't know. Anything stick out to you, Jackie?
That does look like an absolute platter of a game, right? Kilsen, obviously, on a weldy of a form. He still says that he's not quite on QuakeCon form yet, but I disagree. And Cooler, just a living legend in his own right. Yeah, game seven, definitely going to be a bit of a banger. Venger Base, I think, would probably be my dark horse of the day, though, actually. I love watching Venger. We get an Awoken final map bookend in that. And Base... I don't know. It just feels like sometimes you get this base turn up that is just incredible to watch and shows a masterclass of Quake. So game six potentially could be the gold mine of the night.
And then I'm sure a lot of people are eyeballing that last match of the day. Rafa versus Chain, the return of the Sausage King. That one should be a good one to close out the day as well. Chain, been lifting, been hitting the gym. It's going to be a tough match for him, though. Rafa always on point.
Oh, absolutely. It would be so good to see him obviously back competing now, finally. I'm sure everyone across the community cannot physically wait for that. So it would be nice to have that back. Our certified Rafa roundup spot at the end of the day again. It's just like old days, 40.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I'm ready. I'm ready, man. I'm shaking in my boots. I can't wait. I'm not wearing boots, but still very excited.
You're actually just naked below the chest, aren't you?
It's true. It's actually a crop top, technically, but you know, that's neither here nor there. Raisy CNZ, how do you feel about the first game of the day?
Wow, thank you for rounding us into it, and I can't wait. But you've skipped a step. You've gone straight over the standings, and I know you're sat, so we'll keep you there. But let's get into the standings instead, 40. I'm gonna pull
this,
the little
Jackie.
Uno reverse card on you.
It's my first day. What can I say?
I know it's all right. You know, at least this time we're on the same height, so that's worked out quite
for
nicely.
For now, we'll see if the 2x4s can withstand all of the pressure. And we'll also see if the players can withstand some of the pressure here as we take a look at the standings. You can kind of see the spread of everything. As you mentioned before, the NA players kind of starting to get their hands into the fray here, as opposed to, you know, just kind of holding out the bottom. Anyone stand out to you? Anyone kind of climbing the ranks that you're like, okay, I didn't really expect that. I got to give some respect.
I'm having a quick scan through. One of the names I instantly sort of adjusted my eyes to was Zeneku, because it's cool to see that he's now gotten out of, you know, towards the very bottom of the pool. He's starting to push his way back up. He's not far off potentially being able to overtake Sparty here. If you look at the difference in their points, right, that's not much at all. It's crazy to see that Zeneku's finally starting to get, a little bit of limelight on him. I hope there's more progression for him, but I believe he's on a bye week this week, so all of that goes out of the window. Back into what we are looking at across the board. Otherwise, I'd say it's Cypher. I still definitely feel like there's so much more room for Cypher to get maybe another two placements out of this before the end of the season, really break into that top four, top three potentially. That's where I hope to see him finish up.
And I'm sure that's where he wants to be. But yeah, as you mentioned before, shouts to Zeneku really putting in the work. This week, he does get to kind of kick back, relax, and do his studying. He's got his journal out. He's got his notebook. He's going to take notes. He's ready. But shouts to him for Master Zeneku for putting in the work and seeing the results that we all wanted to see for him.
It was actually really nice as well. I don't know, obviously, if people would have caught it, but Zeneku on his Instagram, he posted a little nice picture of him at a picnic with, I believe, a couple people from the Quake community. Avok was there as well. And they were all just sort of chilling. You know, it finally got some outside time to see each other, which must be really nice for Zeneku, obviously. You know, being in Poland, competing in the league, and obviously with everything that went down, right? Probably hasn't had that much time to really explore, but finally linking up with Avok, having a bit of a bye week to chill out and just absorb the Quake, have a bit of a picnic. It's got to be good for the soul.
Oh yeah, chill out, get some sun. I mean, I personally hate it. I burn like a lobster. I stay away from it. You know, I like to be inside watching frags occur away from the sun. But yeah, good for them. Get that vitamin D, you know, talk shop a little bit, relax on your bye week.
Hell yeah, man. Definitely. Well, let's finally get into what you queued up a little bit too prematurely, but that's what you do best.
It happens all
man.
The time.
Right. Well, first game of the day. You already mentioned their name, so let's just start breaking it down immediately. CNZ versus Raisy, two players that are pretty damn impactful in their own right. One of them that always seems to be the bridesmaid, but never really the bride, 40.
It's true. It's true. I personally think, I mean, Raisy's won games and tournaments before. I think he can get a little bit crazy, leaving his opponents a little bit hazy. One thing about Raisy, he's never lazy. So you got to watch out for him. Absolute monster. Hits everything. Plays like a machine. It's oh man, it's just a joy to watch.
Yeah, like a mechanical testament to how good you can be if you really devote the time to learning all of the intricacies that go into Quake Champions, right? Like, he's so good with every champ, with every one of the abilities, and also just in terms of his raw firepower. This man just punches you into next week. Normally with gauntlets. I'm glad we got to see the little highlight there just in time, because he pulls it out so much, and it's disgusting.
It's absolutely brutal. I mean, like I said, it's always a joy to watch. I can't wait to see him. And when he's super on form, it's even more terrifying, because you just see these massive score lines and you're like, this isn't fair. I don't even know if we could broadcast what's happening right now, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, we will, if we get the classic Raisy on the server. Of course, his opponent in CNZ, however, a little bit of a different side of the coin. CNZ. It's hard for me, because I feel like there was definitely a window of opportunity where CNZ could have, you know, really climbed the ranks. But I don't know if he's still on that same growth at the moment, 40.
I mean, he did battle his way back into the league, which is kind of a big deal in and of itself. But yeah, the drill sergeant, you know, he's got to do some work, but he's here for a reason. So it's just a matter of which version of him we're going to see. He has the ability. He has the ability, Jackie. But again, Raisy... I don't know. I don't know. I'm not saying nothing, all right? I'm not saying nothing.
Well, that's the
saying.
Hard part, though, is because it's like, as much as we can go, CNZ is good. He has all the natural tools. You compare that to Raisy, and it's like, well, if CNZ's got a tool belt, Raisy literally has, like, the Batman utility belt. He's just got everything.
He's got the whole Home Depot. Waist, right? He's got, I don't know. Do you guys even have Home Depot across the pond? I'm not sure. Whatever you
call
it.
We got, like, B&Q.
Oh, that's the same thing, I think.
Yeah.
No idea. But, yeah, you know, just lumberyard at his disposal, really.
Literally, it's like he's playing Fortnite. He's just cranking 90s. He's building, you know, mad towers. It's crazy.
Yeah, yeah. Sorry, I just my breakfast came back up a little bit, but yeah, I'm excited to get back into this one. I think in terms of the vetoes, what we got? Molten Falls first. We got Anarchy versus Galena. Raisy's on the Galena, CNZ on the Anarchy. I like that counterplay simply because, you know, as Anarchy, you can gain a lot of speed, whip around corners, but then bam, face checking totems that gives you all the information. It does the damage. So I think that's a pretty good counterplay here for Raisy.
No, it is. It's smart. And then moving out of that, we go straight into Vale. That's Doom for Raisy up against the Aizen. Aizen, he works quite well on Vale. Very close quarters, very tight angles, right? It gives you a little bit more bang for your buck with that old turret even.
Yeah. You could definitely set traps in kind of the Thunderdome where the rockets are, maybe even next to LG, also by the Mega. Pretty much anywhere on the map, the corner's never safe. And then we finally go into Ruins of Sarnath. We got Ranger versus Strog, Raisy on the Strog, CNZ on the Ranger. Love the orb, love the kind of traversal across the entire map, wherever you want to be. Strog also sliding around, lots of speed. So I think this is going to be a pretty good set to kick off the day.
No, it should be. I think it really should be, because it's always fun watching Raisy as well, especially if it's like, you know, you're waking up, you're getting into it, you've opened up Twitch and you've seen the Quakes on, right? You're there with your coffee and you're like, oh, a little bit of Raisy. That's one way to wake you up and get you just jump started in for the day.
Yeah, a little bit of Folgers in your cup, maybe, you know, 6 or 7 Pop-Tarts, depending on what kind of diet you're on, whether you're on a bulk or a cut. I don't know. I don't know your life out there. I just know that we're glad you're here. I'm excited to watch all the frags, and we'll be getting into it shortly. But, you know, Molten, we kind of went over it. What do you think in terms of projections, predictions? What do you got, Jackie? I'm going to put your feet to the fire as I always do.
Straight in. I love it when you do. Honestly, I think as a series, I'm going to have to be quite one-sided here. Raisy probably does take it in a 3-0 fashion. I reckon this is, you know, straight in, he's farming points and he's moving on. But that's not to discredit CNZ entirely. I do reckon there's possibilities in this series, but he's really going to have to play a flawless game. I do think the picks in terms of Molten do give him a little bit of an edge potentially if he can play his cards right. But as you said, you got those totems, you got a lot of info on the Galena. It is going to be a hard ride for him. Maybe Ruins as another potential little upset map. I don't really see him winning on Vale. And I feel like it is certainly going to be a bit of a bust up on Molten. So maybe a chance on Sarnath. That's what I'm thinking. Probably a 3-0 for Raisy, though, to be honest with you, 40.
I think I might have to side with you on that one. I think the games are going to be close. At best, maybe a 2-1 for Raisy. I think CNZ can get on the board for sure. I mean, it all starts with the first map, right? You want to go in with a W. You want to get the victory. You want to get it rolling. But we'll see. CNZ has to be really good at checking those kind of cheeky spots for the totems. Molten Falls lends itself to a lot of those. But it's all down to the first game on Molten Falls as we get into it here. CNZ versus Raisy live for the Quake Pro League, and we are in it right now. CNZ starting on that Anarchy and going straight to HMG, taking the Tele up to Tribolt, and he's just gathering all the weapons in a rail right off the bat. Needs to be careful. It was too close, Jackie, too close. Look at this delay on the Mega.
Yeah, he's really playing with the timing here, trying to throw things off. But in reality, the rotation is actually relatively close. There's only about 2 seconds between them both as Raisy picks up the heavy quite late as well. So that big opening rail could be a telltale sign of things that are to come. Raisy, when he's feeling himself with a rail, he does some disgusting things. He's actually being quite cheeky. From his POV, he's just gone for quite a sneaky totem placement. Gets the face check off onto the rail as well against CNZ. CNZ, he's just taking a pounding here. He needs to get out of there, 40.
He is. He's screaming Adrian. His coach screaming, "You're a bum." He hasn't even used the drugs yet. He's just using these health bubbles as Raisy's in and out. Look at that drop down. Cut off with the LG. Wants to pursue a little bit, but that rocket damage is going to deter him just a little bit.
Do you remember the scene with the turtles where they're just in his flat and he's just screaming out the window? Really weird twist and turn. Fantastic bit of cinematography. Raisy straight back in there with the twists and turns, coming in to try and nip at his heels, somewhat like a snapping turtle. However, CNZ evades for the meantime, keeping his distance between them both. Major item-wise, there is quite a lot of downtime between both of them, about 11 seconds. Heavy's just been snatched by Raisy, and he is on the hunt. he is in position as well to completely deny this mega for CNZ. So he's just got to peace out. He's got to give up so much control.
And Raisy already has that overstat going for him. And this is going to be a fight. Decent rocket, but not good enough. He wants more. Raisy's going to chase. There's the inject, too. This is going to be bad. Rail, 13 HP, the LG, and that's not going to be enough as the shotgun takes him out. Raisy absolutely dominant with that first frag to open it up.
Yeah, big way to start off the game. First frag on the board. Feels like he's pretty much had a complete grasp on all the major items. He's had four of the heavies and two of the megas. There's only one mega that's been taken by CNZ so far. And again, it's spawned in, but there's not really much of a chance for him to get there. The path's just blocked off. And main man Raisy is the bouncer. He's got the jacket on. He's coming up. He's saying, excuse me, son, if you've got any ID. CNZ's trying to get out of there. But it turns out his ID is fake, and that's what happens if you've got a fake ID for it.
Oh, we get bounced out the club. No wristband, no entry, as Raisy gets a second frag and the heavy again, just running the cycle. And this overstack has been up for what feels like forever. There's the drop down, lots of LG here, and that is what CNZ needed. And he pushes in and gets the frag, and that was a great, great bit of LG there.
That was nice. Really smooth on the tracking. Got a lot of damage off. Charges over, picks up the mega to replenish his health, as he did take quite a bit of damage himself throughout that encounter. Timing wise, this could work out relatively nicely for him. If he doesn't overstep his mark, holds towards the heavy, he can keep himself in the fight against Raisy. Raisy trying to do damage from the elevated angle, just spamming down on top of him, but he takes rocket after rocket and loses out. So the scoreline's been equalized, two frags apiece.
And CNZ takes down that totem. That's a good start here. As Raisy, again, built that economy rather quickly. But CNZ turning it around on him, tying it at 2. 3 minutes in, not bad. Here's the jump pad, a little bit of rocket, no damage at all. So no information as Raisy gets away. Scot-free for the time being. Here comes the inject and the play for the heavy.
Lurking on the ledge. The rocket is ready. Ooh, he's taking a couple of shots, and the rails are both coming out, but there's near misses and no real hits. This is also the first time CNZ's been left without any ammunition. Barely stepped past it, so he did have to waste a bit of time going back, but luckily he has those rockets in his arsenal once more. The LG is currently being the prime suspect, and it's keeping him at arm's length. Raisy was trying so hard to get close and deny the mega, but it's just not meant to be.
Drop the totem down and everything, but CNZ, that LG was on point. Raisy kind of whirlwinding his arms, just charging right at him. CNZ putting his hand on his forehead. Here's another attempt here. One good rocket. Very patient on the second and third. 38 HP, and nets the frag again. 4-2 for CNZ. Juice it
up, baby. He's playing really well at the moment. It's also just use the injection to essentially guarantee he can go in to fully commit over on the mega. He's so crisp at the minute with the LG-40. That's got to be the big talking point. That was flawlessly played. Basically just latched on to Raisy and did not miss with a single stroke of that LG. 5-2. The LG's back out again. Finally, he's looking a little bit more mortal, but he will win out with just 12 HP and 15 armor. CNZ has clearly woke up on the right side of the bed.
And Raisy just seems to be pushing in with reckless abandon, maybe miscalculating stack here a little bit, and he needs to be careful not to let this frag lead go out of control here as we round the 5 minute mark, and CNZ is up by 4, doing a great job with that LG. 51%. I mean, both players are shooting nuts right now. 45-51. CNZ getting the best of him, but he's just putting up the frags, and that's what matters here.
It's quite a wild turn of event, considering how close it initially was. The midi, as he's just bouncing him about in the air, trying to batter him. Raisy does win out in that encounter, but it was so damn close and just shows how on point both of them are right now with their gun skill. So finally, it gets back into a somewhat tighter position. Free frag difference between them both. Raisy keeping his totems down, but the rail comes across. He knows exactly where CNZ is. He's committing into it, but he's taking a lot of full frontal damage. They're both low. Surely he's not going to be audacious enough to just swing around. No, he does play it slow, backs off, and gets the major item.
Does have his totems as well. There's the full heal. Not quite overstack yet. He's going to have it in about 17 seconds here as CNZ will grab the mega. He needs to get out here. This could be a lot of damage. The rail will miss and a little bit of LG to push Raisy away. That could have been real bad if Raisy had rockets out.
He drops the totem, trying to play aggressively off the back of it as he's pushing in. The rockets are coming through, and Raisy once again picks CNZ out of the air.
Pushing him into the corner. CNZ had nowhere to go. The health bubble's not going to save you as the rocket's on point. Raisy in and out, and rocket jumps off CNZ's head. Styling, profiling just a little bit here. Getting closer and closer to tying it at 6.
We said that this would probably be a good game to start you off in the morning whilst you're having your coffee, but I wouldn't be surprised if you'd spat it all over your monitor by now with some of the shots we've had coming out, and there's a one frag difference between them both. Raisy, he fires off the warning rocket as it whizzes straight by. They both don the LG, and this is where the fights are going to get quite scary. Oh, it's a frightening height. He drops straight down, commits to the kill with a rocket, Raisy picking him off and finally ties it back up. Six apiece as we go into 7 minutes.
And that is absolutely heartbreaking. Couldn't even steal the heavy away. Needs to be careful. Almost jumps in that rocket. It's actually going to propel him forward. Almost hits the rail. Oh my goodness. That totem almost crushes Cian's at the dreams, but the shotgun still might. What a defensive rocket followed by another one. Totem goes down. Raisy wants it. He's going to eat a rail. 10 HP. Needs to be careful. Somehow the wall saves his life. What is happening, Jackie?
This is madness. That like past 15 seconds of fight between the two of them was just ridiculous. He's heard it as well. The audio cue's there. Raisy should know as he turns back around. Glancing! He's almost finished him off. Oh no, the radio wave's not doing enough to burn him from the inside out. CNZ gets the frag and gets the lead once again.
When he wants the spawn frag, and he's going to get it. That health bubble, very clutch. 8-6, CNZ here taking the lead. He's going to wait on this heavy. He's going to inject. He knows something's wrong. There's Raisy with the LG trying to battle back here. Can he do it? Battle of the LGs. They're crossing the streams. 14 HP. Wants to finish with a shotgun. Can't find the shot. Raisy has 1 HP. CNZ on 14. I can't believe this. Who needs coffee with a game like this?
Oh, absolutely. This is more than enough to get you certainly rubbing those eyes. Oh, man. 8 minutes in. 8-6. Raisy, he's the one on the back foot. And CNZ, he's the one having to scavenge, essentially trying to just keep his nose out of trouble at the minute and stay low to the ground. Hoovering up all of those health bubbles like some kind of health hoover. As we do get close towards 9 minutes, Raisy detects him, knows where he is. He needs to commit into these fights. He has the advantage with stack currently. Mega's up. Mega's going to be snatched. Raisy is building himself a worldie of a stack.
Huge stack here, but here comes the attack. There's a great defensive rocket. Uses the drugs just as a little bit of insurance, just in case. And now CNZ just going to burn away the clock here. Up 2 frags, minute 10 on the board. All the pressure's on Raisy to try and chase. Oh, another great defensive rocket. Totem goes down, but those rockets are just too strong. Raisy has to retreat. A minute left now. Good rail, but before the Mega, is CNZ going to stick around for it? He is. He's actually going to get a rail off. Not going to hit. Raisy's going to try and chase. No dice on that rail as well. But the rail from CNZ, a little cheeky as he drops back down and gives him a little parting gift.
The love tap straight in the rear. Raisy. Not much time. He needs to get both of these frags essentially back to back and play off the spawn for the kill chain. He's only going to have 30 seconds to do so as he drops down as well, receives a horrible present. A railgun straight to the chest. Predictive rocket is amazing, and CNZ could close it down with 9 kills. Didn't quite send him to bed. Raisy was allowed to stay up a little bit later with help of a Mega, but he comes in hot, trying to chase, and he needs to find the kill here. He doesn't have the time, and he's just not being able to execute. CNZ can play the long con and run, and it looks like Molten is going to be CNZ territory.
And that's got to be frustrating for Raisy. CNZ perfectly played there, keeping the distance. The defensive rockets were fantastic into the defensive rails when need be. And he's going to steal this first one away, 8-6. And I think that makes us terrible people, Jackie. Well, technically, I said CNZ could put up one. I'm just saying, not to throw you under the bus.
No.
I'm just saying.
The thing is, I think both of us alluded to the fact we're not counting him out. We're just saying Raisy probably should 3-0 this, right? Like, that's kind of a fair assumption to make. However, that was a very nice display from CNZ.
The LG.
It was,
Chef's
right, but here's my point to this. I feel like on the flip side of things, Raisy in the early game there, it felt like he had no reserve. He wouldn't recoil. He was just hitting over and over and over again. That's probably the most aggressive, I'd say most unnecessarily aggressive Raisy I've seen in a couple of weeks.
Well, usually he could make it work. So I think a little bit of miscalculation in the stack. And then again, CNZ at one point was hitting 51, 53% LG. That's going to stop anyone dead in their tracks. So I think Raisy was caught off guard a little bit. He did give up those free frags a little bit too early. And CNZ just got barely enough to get away with it. So it's still a very, very close game, especially near the end there. We saw those skirmishes where players were down to 15, 1 HP at a time. Like, that one was close. That one was very, very close.
Oh, there was literally the difference of like one rail here or there for Raisy or one more chip from the LG. It would have been a completely different game. But instead, this is the cards that we have been dealt. CNZ coming in with a huge victory on the opening map of Molten Falls.
That LG, man. Raisy thinking he can just drop a totem and kind of bully his way onto some of these items, and CNZ is like, absolutely not, sir.
He just didn't miss, especially on this one as well. It was so clean. There's like one instance for a millisecond where he comes off him on the bounce pad, then readjusts. Every time he was winning. When they went on to 1v1 LG fights, you could just count CNZ was going to take it.
Yeah, absolutely. And some of these rockets from Raisy were incredible, but just not enough in the end. This rocket too, just denying that heavy at the last second when CNZ wanted it. Like, there's so many close moments. I'm excited for Vale. This is going to be nuts.
Yeah. And you've hit the nail right on the head, right? Vale coming up next. Aizen for CNZ. Doom pick through for Raisy. What do you reckon? How do you think this has shaped the storyline now? Is it rock the boat in your mind?
I think a little bit. This is going to be one in a million. And I think the Doom guy pick is always nice because you get to dodge those rockets. But as we just talked about, CNZ kind of, his LG's nuts. So that double jump doesn't really do much for you. We'll see. I think Raisy might be a little bit more reserved here after some of those frags didn't go his way. Maybe. We'll see. Raisy might just get a little more crazy on this one. But again, you also have the robotic kill death machine on Aizen's side. So you got to be careful of those traps. You got to be wary kind of where you jump into. It's going to be a close one, but I think Raisy's going to adjust just enough to kind of take this one.
Yeah. I would probably be inclined to agree with you. I feel like Raisy is the sort of player where if he loses a map like this in the series, he's not someone that's really going to get disheartened, you know, and sort of slump his head over. Instead, it will be like roll up the sleeves, straight back in for the second map, and he'll want to prove a point on the server. So wouldn't be surprised if this is where he just comes out of the gate looking fresh to death and absolutely swinging for vengeance. Hopefully, this is just as good as the first map, because the series already has been full of some juicy little moments.
Yeah, I'm sure, you know, if you ask him, he'd be like, oh, I was eating breakfast. Like, that was a warm-up game. I'm done now.
I was halfway through a banana,
put my plate
away.
Yeah, let's go. I'm ready to go, so we'll see.
Yeah, hopefully Raisy can raise some hell. Let's smoke in Joe Fraser, the Hellraiser, raising hell with the flavor. As we are ready for the second map in the series, it's time for Vale.
CNZ gonna start off on that heavy. He wants this rocket. Down goes the Deathbot immediately as he's trying to secure it, and the LG coming out from Raisy. Good damage there. Ooh, CNZ, please. Oh, God. Oh, no, the trap from Raisy is so strong into the machine gun, 4 HP, and he finally finishes the frag, and that's just a rough start for CNZ.
And this is already the worrying signs of when you come straight back in with Raisy feeling reinvigorated and ready for action. I certainly am going to be a little bit worried about where this goes. Nearly the rapid transition on the rail. He darts himself forward using that doom jump and basically just uppercut CNZ out of action. That was disgusting.
Now he's protecting this LG, and Deathbot comes down, but that's not going to buy him enough time, and instead he's going to deal so much damage with the rocket. CNZ that needs to be careful of the acid as well, but Raisy wins that mega, deals great damage. CNZ going to stack up off what he can, but that was very, very close.
Raisy, one rocket, not going to use it. Instead, takes a little bit of chip as he turns around the corner, but grabs himself the heavy, and he's fully committing to the fight now, chasing. It's like a very aggressive game of hide and seek. When you get caught, you're not going to be breathing. CNZ taken down, Raisy with a third frag, and he's still hunting. Look at him. He's like the predator right now.
Yeah, he's just covering all these spawn angles, making sure that weapons do not go to CNZ for free here, as he's going to go through the telly and make his way up to the mega area there, taking out the Deathbot. Now he has free reign to kind of push in off this here. Needs to be careful. Does double back for the heavy in time, and this could be a good trap, but instead it's going CNZ's way as he pushes through the telly. The rockets are fantastic from Raisy. Good telly play to avoid further damage here. Both players very weak, and he's just hunting. He's waiting for this drop, daring him to grab that health bubble. CNZ very patient. Well played.
Mega's back up. Raisy has his gaze set on it. He'll snatch it with both arms and then get back to moving. Hunting. And good adjustment as well. That rail shot was sickeningly nice. A beautiful back tap. CNZ retreating because of it. Nearly a follow-up 40.
Just grazing the cheeks there. Again, the Deathbot dealt with nicely here. Great rail into the Thunderdome here. Almost hits another one, but he's good. Right through, shotgun out the rocket from CNZ into the rail. And that double jump almost caused Raisy here. 40 HP, very weak. He's going to grab the mega just in the nick of time. He's going to go for this. Rockets out. Is he going to rail through the grate? Nope, not so great indeed here. Raisy's going to opt for the 50 armor, trying to make a play on this heavy. Midground secured by CNZ. Rockets flying. Can he get the frag? And just the tickle is enough from Raisy from down below.
Oh, man. CNZ, you'd imagine he'd be quite disheartened throughout the course of that fight as well. And Raisy, no, please don't do it like this. The gauntlet from CNZ, what?
And that's why you don't bring Fist to a knife fight here, as Raisy gets that frag back. A little bit of a glimmer of hope for CNZ there as he punches Raisy in the face with some brass knuckles. And Raisy says, "How dare you, sir? Do you know who I am? I am the one who knocks you out with a gauntlet." 5-1 for Raisy right now.
That's mad, by the way. That entire encounter is just absolutely ridiculous and is the embodiment of the type of Quake you get when you have Raisy just playing his heart out, coming back in, clearly not happy with what went down on Bolton, and showing that beautiful predictive rocket, allowing him to initiate. He is taking all of the damage that's being chucked in by CNZ with both arms, happy as Larry, carries on to pummel him, and it's 6-1.
And he does a great job of staying behind the wall, still dealing damage, strafing in and out, making sure that Deathbot doesn't get any additional damage for CNZ. That was just super well played by Raisy. 6-1, 4 minutes in. Looking very much in control here. Good dodge on that rocket before the heavy comes up. Does take a little bit of damage off that pickup. Looking for the rail angles. Can't quite find anything here as the skirmish for the Mega is about to break out. Is it going to be a rocket jump? There's a great rocket. Almost hits him right in the face. CNZ, a little bit timid, doesn't want to push too much, and he's going to eat a rail for it. And now Raisy's on the hunt yet again.
Chasing him. Good timing. He can actually cut him off here on a rotation around the corner as well. He knows exactly where he is. Has to deal with Timothy, the troublesome turret bot. Will kill him. Spots him. Big LG. Doesn't miss a beat with it. Even on the adjustment, using that double jump to clear the long barrier in front of him. Look at the smooth transition as well. Oh, from LG to rail. Everything this man does looks so cinematic.
It's almost as if he can't fail, and he will prevail as Raisy, again, cycling the item 7-1, just growing stronger and stronger here. Another rail here. He's going to go for another one. Switches to LG. He wants to finish this. Rockets will do it in the Thunderdome as CNZ can't get any traction. Can't get anything going.
All right. Looks like he's stuck in the mud right now. Raisy!
Ooh.
Oh, no. I thought he was actually somehow going to be able to steal that one away and snatch it. Or other storyline could have been killed by the turret, of course. But he does win out. He's chasing back in. He's got CNZ trapped. He's hitting some worldy rail shots, but it's just not enough.
Good LG from CNZ here as Raisy just heads rail out, trying to make something happen, but it seems like CNZ can get that frag or two, but it takes him, you know, 6 or 7 to even get chip damage well enough to get in. As the death bot goes down again, Raisy needs to be careful here. A little bit weak. He's going to grab the 50 armor. What a rail from down below.
Oh no. Dude. As if he's just stayed scoped the entire time on the rail.
10 HP.
What? Boy, this is madness. Oh, I mean, the issue is, of course, with that sort of stack, Raisy comes round. He's got very proficient skills at tickling, and that's just what he does with the LG.
The world's best. Every time CNZ gets a frag, he just takes so much damage that Raisy can stroll in and finish what he started. As you see the scoreline, 10-3 here. CNZ reeling. And Raisy just putting his foot on the gas, it looks like. There's a good predictive rocket right around the corner, forcing CNZ back out up the jump pad. So much LG. Deathbot trying to stop him. The rocket jump's not going to land, and he needs to be careful taking too much damage here. There's a great rail, and he's stuck in between a turret and a hard spot here. But he's chasing. Raisy doesn't care. Up the jump pad again. Rocket's shotgun finally taking him out. 2 HP again. Raisy does so much damage off that chase. Mega is going to go to CNZ and a great rail shot. And this should slow down Raisy a little bit, but like I said, he doesn't seem to care.
That was just bizarre. Surely you'd be thinking he'd slow it down. Like, you can tell Raisy, he's flipped that switch, right? This is just like X Games mode Raisy. He's come out here on the hunt for vengeance, really. And that's all he's doing. He's going into every encounter, no matter if it looks like statistically he'd be down. He just doesn't stop. Rocket after rocket right now. He's trying to blow CNZ into next week, but unfortunately, he's living in the present, and he gets a present. Mega responds in kind, though. Raisy with a rail. Oh, that's just filth. That's just absolute filth.
CNZ doing a great job surviving with 25 HP, picking up the Mega, dancing all day, but apparently all day is not enough as Raisy finally gets that frag. There's a good rail. Almost hits a follow-up, but Raisy clips him 11-4, trying to find the angle of CNZ. He's going to back himself into a corner now, and this is going to be really hard. Another defensive rail. And on the way out, Raisy gets one of his own. So good trades from both players here. But again, Raisy just has such an advantage. Seven frags up. Time is ticking. All the pressure's on CNZ. He's trying to get the angle again. There's the drive by rail. Won't land, but he's going to push with the LG. Swaps to rockets last minute. And that armor is going to be the death of you. CNZ saw it. He needed it. But instead, he just ate a rocket.
Rail off the rail, dropping 90s across the board. Trying to hold it on the close peak. Wanted to send himself flying in. Like, he was the rocket, but he couldn't get the propulsion off. It won't matter, though, because he's still landing in the follow-up rails. Scavenges the smaller items for now to rebuild himself. Unfortunately, just barely clipping onto the map geometry there with the follow-up shot. And he has to peace out. He's got to waste a bit of time in this encounter.
I think at this point, Raisy is just taking victory laps here. A minute 30 left, eight frags down, CNZ that has to make magic happen. Those rockets, oh my god, almost out the window. Good rail here. CNZ very weak, needs to be careful as Raisy looking for the final shot. HMD out, that's a great rail. That can equalize, and it actually tilts in CNZ's favor here. Now he grabs the heavy. Could he do this? A minute 15, do you believe, Jackie?
Oh man, not if the gauntlet's out. He's trying it. Thing is, this is where Raisy will continuously do this sort of stuff as well. When he knows he's got himself into such a ludicrously large lead that he can just charge in with the gauntlet out and try and cut him up like a bit of prime rib. Raisy burnt to a crisp around the corner by the LG, taking him down finally. But it's a 13-6. You've got about 50 seconds left on the clock, and Raisy will just push until the end of this one. The series has got to go 1-1.
I think his W key's just broken. He can't help it. He's just playing around it. Fists are popped now as he wants a piece of him. He's going to chase. Backs away, not today, Disco Lady here. CNZ grabs the Mega and has rail out. But I think you're right. Raisy kind of knows this one's in the bag, and he gave him a little beep boop on the nose with the gauntlet. Kind of a nod to him like, yeah, you got me earlier, but I still got 20 seconds to try and get you. The LG from above, he's going to drop down, absolutely electrifying from the Maestro boy here. CNZ is going to have to swallow this one, and I think you're right. 1-1 is the way the series is going.
Yeah, there's nothing else that can be done, right? There's physically no time. There's no chances left. Raisy has pulled out all of the stops, and he gives us one final parting gift, a little railgun exit piece as he takes down CNZ 15-7. Oh, that was just murder.
That was. Look at the percentages that CNZ was hitting, though. I know they don't tell the whole story, but his play was great. It's just Raisy, like, if the W key is broken on your opponent's keyboard, you just have to always be ready to hit everything. So even with hitting high percentage rockets LG, like, Raisy's just in there. He's just in there. You can't stop him.
He physically can't. He just keeps going, man. Once he had built up that, I'd say momentum, but it was kind of like that from the get-go, right? He walked into the second map, and it's one of those worrying factors. If Raisy drops a map, it reinvigorates him. It's almost as if the frustration is used, right? He's like a Sith Lord, 40. He just uses that hatred as his power.
It fuels him. It really does.
Yeah.
That gauntlet was probably the worst decision CNZ could have made, but I don't know. I think for every three or four frags that Raisy got, CNZ was putting up one, and they're just... so much damage coming out from Raisy every time they would battle that even when CNZ would win, Raisy could just stroll in and kind of get the refrag immediately. Just really well played there. And then kind of a mind game near the end when he had the lead. He's a little bit of gauntlet, a little bit of just maybe disrespect, maybe getting in his head for the third and final map. And that's just Raisy. That's just Raisy, especially on that map. We've seen highlights of Raisy just with gauntlet shenanigans.
I think if we do have to point out one play that was probably the big standout, though, it's got to be the fact he busts out the gauntlet. There it was on the replay that's just gone by, right? The fact that he's got out the gauntlet. He's tried to go in for the pummel. He's throwing fists all over the place, trying to connect a haymaker, and just gets taken down by by the gauntlet. Ridiculous. I thought that would have been a bit of a tilter, but no, if anything, again, it just got him more ready for the action.
Yep. He was primed and ready. I think this third map is going to be a bloodbath. I'm excited to get into it. Ruins of Sarnath. Do you stay true to your prediction of Raisy taking it? Do you see CNZ stealing this one away? I mean, what do you think, Jackie?
No, I do think at this point now it's a 2-1. Raisy's going to clean up at the end here and he will walk away. It's Sarnath. He's on Strog. He is going to be flying through the map, using that speed to his advantage, taking every possible peek and just throwing out shapes, mate. That's what I'm expecting.
High flying shotgun, maybe even some gauntlet. I don't know, Raisy. I don't know. We might see it. But I think CNZ does have a good pick in Ranger with the orb. You can kind of see from the rail area orbing up to T-Con getting into the mega quickly. I think it's going to be close, but I think you're right. Raisy might edge this one out and maybe even get some gauntlet shenanigans. I know people at home want to see that. I know they want to see it.
Especially after that little teaser that we got with, you know, with the fists coming out and the gauntlet being used. That's the sort of play that gets you, you know, frothing at the mouth, waiting for a little bit more. So hopefully we get some of that thrown in on Ruins. This will be our bookend to our first series, the third and final map. We expected this to be a gem, and it's been everything that we anticipated.
It's been quite the uncut gem here. CNZ's going to start out on the heavy, straight into the rail, and now he might play a little denial on the LG. Free rail here, as Raisy going off the jump pad, just dancing all day, trying to get out for free, and that little bit of rocket damage is going to be enough to get him out, at least for the time being here. But CNZ doing a good job of playing patiently. Out comes the peeker for a little bit of scouting here, right into the face. CNZ not ready for it. It's a great rail on the cross, though.
Oh, man. We're 30 seconds in. Already some of the encounters they've had have been quite worrying. CNZ, he makes his play towards the Mega. Raisy, on the other side of the coin, will pick up the Heavy. They get back into an encounter as well. Fighting down for the high ground, CNZ takes a bit of damage from the rail. He's low on armor, and he's just playing on the corner, listening out for the audio cues and trying to detect what exactly Raisy is up to. Peaks, brilliant timing, good pre-planning on the face as well. Raisy, taking a bit of a hit from that. Both major items are going to be up at the exact same time as well. So it depends if CNZ is going to play it safe and just back off towards the Mega, or if he wanted to run the risk of dropping and instigating a fight there in the heavy room. Seems like he did go for the initial option.
The items are traded. Wow, what a drive-by rail there from Raisy. CNZ trying to play slow, getting caught out. Items are synced up here, and CNZ needs to be very careful. Raisy just flying in, eating a rail, needs to be careful. Heavy machine gun switch, 70 HP. CNZ playing with his life right now as it's tied zero, but for how long? Going to grab a 25 health bubble. That's going to put him out of rail range for now. The rocket's going to miss. The jump over rail's going to miss as well, and CNZ needs to be super careful here as Heavy goes to Raisy again. Items traded out. CNZ trying to add a little bit of delay to the Mega here, but still, all in all, Raisy just plus forwarding in. There's the orb. There's the play with the LG. Is he going to be able to get it? The rocket from underneath. Absolutely explosive. Raisy takes the first frag.
Oh, man. Raisy with the rail. Ready to do some damage as he shoots out the warning shot. Peeking. Sends in the peeker. Trying to chase him down, but he won't be able to actually get it off. Ready with the rockets as well as he waits on the close angle, dropping down, knowing the heavy's up, and he'll slide into action. This could be both major items going his way if he's just a little bit faster. Wasn't quite quick enough. So they do both split the major items apiece this rotation.
Yeah, CNZ doing a good job of not letting the stack get a little crazy here. As the items are flipped, relatively. 1-4 for heavies in favor of Raisy. 4-1 megas in terms of CNZ. So they're doing a good job of at least maintaining the ground in which they claimed earlier. Here, Pika come out again for a little bit of information. Nothing doing in terms of damage. And I think they're just going to be content just swapping these items back and forth. The delay's not big enough, but CNZ adds more and more each time, eventually trying to play on this heavy.
Raisy. Seems like he just wants to go for the wall face. Actually holds on top of it and uses the rocket as well. It's been quite a close game so far. In the busts up they've had, Raisy knows exactly where he is and he's really trying to test his boundaries of committing to this. Quick flick on the rocket. Nice little 35 damage. Immediately bounces out. Should get the heavy for free. Ooh. CNZ, I thought he was actually going to try and muddy the timing a little bit on the pickup of the Mega, but no, it was just a brief bit of downtime. And Raisy, he's on the hunt.
Ooh, CNZ with a good job dodging that peeker here. But again, his stack is just so low in comparison to Raisy here. Raisy going through the TP. He's going to chase. There's the orb up to get away. And the rail almost catches him. So dangerous. CNZ reeling right now. 56 HP, no armor. And now he's just trying to stay alive. He's doing his best to just not be caught at any costs here and just get back on the Mega, and somehow he does.
I'm so surprised he's actually been able to pull that off and got away with it. Raisy coming around the corner. This is where things could finally start to go bad for the man. He's taken two full attacks straight to the lips and a fair amount of damage. CNZ, will he attempt to capitalize? Pika play, that's brilliant. Doing it midair as he drops down towards the heavy room. I love that.
Really, really nice play from Raisy there. And CNZ playing a bit of a survival horror game, it feels as though. As, again, items will get traded out, but he's just constantly been on the back foot. He did have very good damage output, but he let Raisy stack back up, and he's facing the same challenge that he faced 4 minutes ago. Raisy outstacks him. CNZ playing very slow in the TCON here, and Raisy just going to rail away from outside in the courtyard. There's one great rail, 98 HP, 25 bubble to stack him back up, but CNZ on the back foot almost this entire duel, it feels as though.
It really does. He's not just had much of an opportunity to do anything, to be honest. But a few moments where Raisy's given him a little bit of timing, like right now. But Raisy, after getting the Mega, surely you just fully commit to this. You know you should win on this encounter. He's so low. And to be honest with you, Foy, it almost feels like he's gifted him his life there.
Yeah, the peeker play a little bit mistimed there as he kind of doubled back and thought he was in the armor room. He needs to be careful going up this jump pad here, and he's going to force down this LG rocket combo. It was just madness. It was madness. Raisy wins out on it. Two up, and all of CNZ's hard work gone off the spawn. Here's the chase and another frag from Raisy, and just like that, he might open this wide, wide open, Jackie.
Oh yeah, this is where he is going to get complete dominance and map control of both of the major items, because the rotations are just going to play into his hands. He's going to do this sort of stuff where he comes around the corner wielding the railgun like it's a shotgun and just detonating it into your chest. Raisy is a very scary man when he's fired up, and when you give him complete control of the items and he has the weight to throw around, that's when it gets worrying. CNZ playing the close angle. I like the idea with a trap. Even better on the play with the Dire Orb to try and get himself out of trouble. The issue is he still is in trouble. Ooh. Although the shotgun has other ideas in mind. Strikes against Raisy.
CNZ, a seasoned skeet shooter there, as Raisy flying through the sky. CNZ says pull, and he gets his frag. 4-1. Needs to be careful. Here's the push with the LG. The rocket's not even going to fire here as Raisy gets that refrag relatively quickly. 5-1. Right off the spawn. Unfortunate. And there's the gauntlet that everyone wanted. Raisy hit him with the Liptons a little bit. Cup of tea, mate.
That's disgusting, man. Tetleys have come through in full force. He's cut him to pieces. Oh, and he's going in for a little bit more as well. Surely not another one. The gauntlet's coming out. You can see he was still teasing us. He wanted a follow-up back-to-back gauntlet frag. Oh, this man is just striving for glory.
Oh, Raisy. He's got a highlight reel waiting. Someone's making a movie of just gauntlet kills from Raisy in professional matches. That's how nuts he is. Great rocket from CNZ with the follow-up, and he gets the frag, punishing Raisy. A little bit of overconfidence there, but with 3 minutes left and five frags needed, maybe it's calculated. Raisy does need to be careful now. There's two good rails to take out the peeker and one to do damage onto the Strog here. CNZ trying to establish some boundaries in this relationship here. Still five frags down, looking for more rails. He's going to re-up on him here. Now he's just going to wait patiently.
CNZ, is he going to end up being CN dead here if he turns at the wrong time? Dire Orb's nearly back, fires off the warning rail, but it won't actually connect. Raisy hiding behind the broken wall, taking the side strafe peeks. He gets himself on the elevated angle, sends in the peeker to fully commit and try and punish. Response from the rail is good from CNZ, but both of the major items are coming up soon, and CNZ has to bail out. He has the Dire Orb. He can use that to fully move himself from this awkward fight if he needs to. Instead, just walks in, picks up the Mega, and leaves himself with 2 minutes to try and find the required frags to tie the scoreline.
Raisy just playing so aggressive, looking for all these angles. He's going to go through the Tele Orb, and the rocket is going to be enough to net ZNZ that frag. Four frags down, 2 minutes. Well within the realm of possibilities, but he needs to play a little bit quicker here. Heavy's going to be the first item up, looking for the rail from down below, and you see Raisy there on the wireframe just flying by. He has rockets now to play defensive. Heavy's going to go to CNZ, but the chase needs to happen. A minute 30, four frags.
CNZ going in. He knows he needs to fully commit, right? He's the one that has to make these fights happen. Raisy's not going to give him any unnecessary opportunities. He's sat on the ledge, perched over like a very aggressive pigeon right now. Will he get these shots off? Just switching between the rocket and the rail, but not given a chance. He needs to instigate this. He's just wasting too much time, 40.
Wasting way too much time, and he almost got out scot-free. The rocket jump into the rail is going to damage Raisy a little bit, but CNZ needs to be a little bit quicker here. I think he's barely sees the wings here. He's going to clip them, maybe. Can he do it? Finding with the shotgun? No, anything. He needs damage. Raisy's doing such a great job of just wasting time right now.
And that's all he's got to do. Essentially just has to sit there with a stopwatch up and keep an eye on it. finally CNZ commits and swoops in, doing a little bit of damage, but it's not really enough. And he's taking more. He's wasting too much time here. And if Raisy carries on like this for another 30 seconds, that's it. It'll be him walking away with a 2-1 split on the series, and he's still not even killed him.
Still alive, and he's probably going to grab this health bubble. There's a rocket. Is it going to be enough? Raisy's dancing all day in the Batcave as Alfred can't serve him up his breakfast. 3-7 right now, and Raisy has won this game hiding back here pretty much for a minute and a half solid.
There's
the
orb play,
a little bit of misdirection, the LG. He can't kill him, and there it is. Finally, he pushes in, but at what cost? 5 seconds, Raisy takes it 7-4. What a game.
I don't know. I don't understand, 40. He could have just gone in. If he would have gone in, there was a slim yet possibility that he could have actually got back into the game. Instead, he just sat there, just watching from a distance, observing Raisy just waste the time. I don't know.
It's brutal, because if you dive in one side, Strog's already fast enough where he could crouch slide out, or you just take massive rocket damage off the sound cue. But there's got to be something that you could do kind of with the orb play, maybe throw it one side, jump in the other, and then if he tries to escape, something. But I mean, Raisy did a great job of just eating all of the time in the world there in the Batcave, just chilling. Kicked his feet up, relaxed. You saw how long it took for CNZ to even get a frag, and Raisy just played that really well. And then we saw that beautiful gauntlet. Just a little chef's kiss from Raisy here, just a little gift from Raisy.
He was just, you know, kicking back with his sidekicks, rocking fly kicks. That's pretty much all he was doing during that encounter. He didn't need to fight, he didn't need to peek, he kept himself out of sight, and we just didn't really hear a peep from him. CNZ, he loses that one. Unfortunately, he does only get one map win out of the series, but that's still pretty damn good. Taking a map off Raisy, you know, even this late into the competition, is still quite a feat.
Yeah, that last map was closer than we'd imagine here. Just the delay on that play.
Yeah.
You gotta think that that's maybe what did it. He had the opportunity. He just needed to go quick. The hesitation cost him. And look at this. Just, brutal. Raisy just doesn't care. And I love it. It's great. It's fantastic to watch.
It is damn fun. Like, Raisy, literally just as a competitor and as a professional, I think he's one of the more enjoyable ones when you see him just wilding out and doing some outrageous things. Because it's almost as if he's just on a whole another planet of confidence, right? If you annoy him, he will come back in with that gauntlet. He'll do whatever he wants.
Absolutely. I mean, you don't get the nickname of the God Slayer by being fearful of any opponent. So that's just Raisy in a nutshell right there. Fearless.
Absolute madness. It really is quite crazy how many gauntless kills this man gets out. Shocking, shocking stuff for you. Well, that is the end of our first series, as that one has been rounded out. CNZ, unfortunately, only gets the one map, but that is still a victory under his belt. Raisy, though, 2-0 in the series. Were you impressed, 40?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But a little bit expected. I'm not going to say that I was right with the 2-1, but I was right with the 2-1.
Yeah, that's fair enough. I did say 3-0, but I reckon there certainly could have been some leeway. As you said, maybe he was still finishing his breakfast on that opening map. You never know. Molten aside, though, Raisy has taken it. 2-1 split on the scoreline. Still an awful lot more Quake to come tonight, though. And hopefully, it's only going to get better from this point forward. Nosfa versus Effortless up next. I know you were excited for that one, 40.
Always, always, always ready to watch the NA boys battle it out.
Hell yeah. It should be a damn good affair. If you are enjoying the show, though, let us know on Twitter as well. Hashtag Quake Pro League. You can hit us up and tell us what you're thinking of the show. For now, though, go rehydrate yourselves, get some water, and come back in for Nosfa Effortless after the break.